but I believed that in other parts of the country I would find strange people and see new sights. And so I set out upon my wandering journey. I have been a wanderer for nearly a full year, and now my wanderings have brought me to this splendid castle."
"I suppose," said the Tin Woodman, "that in this year you have seen so much that you have become very wise?"
"No," replied Woot thoughtfully. "I am not at all wise, I beg to assure your Majesty. The more I wander, the less I find that I know. For in the Land of Oz, much wisdom and many things may be learned."
"To learn is simple. Don't you ask questions?" inquired the Scarecrow.
"Yes, I ask as many questions as I dare, but some people refuse to answer questions."
"That is not kind of them," declared the Tin Woodman. "If one does not ask for information, he seldom receives it. So I, for my part, make it a rule to answer any civil question that is asked me."
"So do I," added the Scarecrow, nodding.
"I am glad to hear this," said the wanderer, "for it makes me bold to ask for something to eat."
"Bless the boy," cried the Emperor of the Winkies. "How careless of me not to remember that wanderers are usually hungry. I will have food brought you at once."
Saying this, he blew upon a tin whistle that was suspended from his tin neck, and at the summons a servant appeared and bowed low. The Tin Woodman ordered food for the stranger, and in a few minutes the servant brought in a tin tray heaped with a choice array of good things to eat, all neatly displayed on tin dishes that were polished till they shone like mirrors. The tray was set upon a tin table drawn before the throne, and the servant placed a tin chair before the table for the boy to seat himself.